Hi, my name is Alissa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. And today, I want to show you a really cool project that you can do with number six plastic. Now, the grown-ups out there might remember Shrinky Dinks. These were kits that came with sheets of plastic and special markers, and you could decorate them, and then you put them in the toaster oven. And the plastic shrinks down, and it was really cool. This is the exact same thing. You don't need to go out and buy special plastic. You don't need special markers. You need number six plastic and Sharpies. Now, depending on where you live and what kinds of things your city can recycle, you may or may not be able to recycle this kind of plastic. If you're not sure what I mean by number six plastic, most plastics come with a number somewhere on there that you can see. This one has a number one. And this one has a number five. Now, even if you can recycle these plastics, it's always best to first try and reduce your use of them. And then to try and reuse them in some way. These are great. You might get these from the supermarket or if you get takeout, but you can totally keep them and use them for leftovers or for craft materials or whatever. Use them until they fall apart and then recycle them, rather than going out and buying containers just for this purpose. Anyway, the plastic that we're talking about today is number six plastic. Now, if you're going to do this project, it's really important that you make absolutely sure that the plastic that you have has a number six on it. This one here looks kind of the same, but it's number one plastic. A lot of times, number one and number six can look a lot alike. So you always want to double check and make sure that the plastic you have is marked with this number six. If it's not marked, don't use it because it can make a big mess and fumes and it's really bad. So if it doesn't have a number at all, don't use it. Or if you're just not sure, don't use it. If it's clearly marked with a number six, it's safe to use for this project. Here's the things you'll need to do this project. Some permanent markers, a pair of scissors, a piece of brown paper cut from a brown paper shopping bag, and you might need a hole punch. And of course, you'll need some number six plastic. The other thing you'll need is a toaster oven or a regular oven. And you'll need to get grown-ups' permission and help to do that. Before we get started on a real project, I just want to show you how much a piece of plastic shrinks in the oven. You can see I've got two pieces here, and they're the same size. I've marked them both with how big they are, and also they both have the letters A, B, C, and a red square on them. I'm going to put just one of them in the oven. So you can see this shrank a lot. It's about half the size that it was when we started. It's also a little bit yellow, and that's probably because I should have been a little more careful about washing my plastic before I used it. But anyway, keep this in mind when you're making your creation. You don't want to start with anything that's too small because it's really going to shrink a lot. You can draw anything you want on your plastic. You can make a design or a picture, really anything you can imagine. You can cut the piece of plastic down into a different shape. I was thinking of cutting this one into maybe a heart or a star shape, but I think I'll leave it the way it is. And then, this is important. If you think you're going to want to hang your plastic on something, like a decoration in the window, or maybe turn it into a keychain or a tag to hang onto your backpack, you'll want to cut a hole in it before you put it in the oven. There we go. I think that's ready.
Set your toaster oven or your regular oven to about 350. You can let it preheat if you want, but if you're being impatient, that's okay. It just means that it'll take a little longer for your project to finish. Put your piece of plastic on the brown paper and then place it in the oven on a piece of foil or on a small baking sheet. You can see I'm wearing gloves because the oven is hot. Make sure you wear gloves or oven mitts or use a pair of tongs so that you don't burn yourself. Now watch what happens. There it goes. So what's going to happen is your plastic will curl up, shrink, and then flatten back out. Sometimes this can take a couple minutes, and sometimes it happens really fast, like this one here. Sometimes you'll be watching and the piece of plastic will curl over and stick to itself and you'll think that the whole thing is ruined. But I've done this project hundreds of times and it always works out in the end. When your plastic isn't changing or shrinking anymore, it's time to take it out of the oven. Again, use gloves or a pair of tongs. And when it first comes out of the oven, that plastic is still really hot. So wait a couple of minutes before you touch it.
Here's my project. As you can see, not only is it a lot smaller than it was before it went into the oven, but it's also a lot harder. The plastic started out really flimsy and easy to bend. Now it's much sturdier. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with my project. Maybe I'll tie a piece of string onto it and use it for a bookmark. I hope you get the chance to try homemade Shrinky Dinks, and if you do, please post pictures below of your projects. Please keep checking back with us on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more fun science and art activities, story times, yoga, and lots of other fun things that you can try at home. Thanks for joining me today, and we'll see you next time.